Hello friends, welcome to Programming Concepts. My name is Amit and this is part 2 of ASP.NET Core MVC tutorial. In this video, for a change, we will act as an astrologer and try to figure out how the future of .NET will look like. This is continuation to part 1, Introduction to .NET Core. And before moving forward to this video, I strongly recommend you to go through that video. I shared the link in the description. In this video, we will try to address two most concerned questions of .NET developers, the developers who are already having experience in .NET platform. First, is .NET Core is going to be the future of .NET developers? Second, will .NET survive against other open source technologies giants like Java, PHP, Python, Node, etc.? And before moving forward, I would like to add disclaimer that these will be my personal views and I would really appreciate your discretion in the matter. Alright, in that note, let's try to figure out whether .NET Core is going to be the future of .NET developers. For that, let me take you to the development blog of Microsoft. And this blog is written by Scott stating .NET Core is the future of .NET. But wait. Who is Scott? Scott Hunter is the Director of Program Management of .NET. And he written this blog almost 1.5 years back on May 6th, 2019. This is the time when .NET Core 3.2 RC was in progress. Just in case if you are not aware of what RC, GA and LTS is all about, so these are the terminologies used in software development world. When we say RC means release candidate, very basic. When we say GA, that means general availability. When we say LTS, that means long-term support. In this blog, Scott has described a brief journey of .NET Core and also described a future plan of Microsoft on .NET. I will share the link in the description. Let me take you directly to the summary. So here, new applications should be built on .NET Core. Pretty clear message, all right? So .NET Core is where future investments in .NET will happen. Existing applications are safe to remain on .NET framework, which will be supported. Existing applications that want to take advantage of new features in .NET should consider moving to .NET Core, a big statement. As we plan into the future, we will be bringing in even more capabilities to the platform. I guess these four lines of summary put a very strong statement not only to the outside world, but also to the software developer, in fact, the .NET developer community, that this is a very high time to move on to .NET Core. But wait, let me take you to another blog written by Richard Lander. And that blog is also written on May 6th, 2019. But who is Richard Lander? Richard Lander is the program manager of .NET team. So the title of this blog is Introducing .NET 5. But wait, we were just talking about .NET Core and now this guy is talking about .NET 5. Two senior resources from Microsoft. One is talking about .NET Core, another one is talking about .NET 5. Both blogs published on May 6, 2019. So what the hell .NET 5 is? Let's get back to the slide. So .NET 5. So previously, we had two versions of .NET. One is called .NET Framework and another one is called .NET Core. But now, we have single version with the power of both as .NET 5. Microsoft added more than 50,000 .NET Framework APIs to .NET Core platform. With Visual Studio 2019 version 16.8 onwards, you can take advantage of .NET 5. With .NET 5, you can write your code in C#, and that will work across platform. That's the big thing. Not all apps available in .NET 5, and that's when .NET 6 comes into a picture. With upcoming .NET 6, we are expecting your same code work across platform, even for Windows Form and all missing apps in .NET 5. Let's get back to Richard Block. So there will be just one .NET going forward, and you will be able to use it to target Windows, Linux, macOS, iOS, Android, tvOS, watchOS, and WebAssembly, and more. Finally, we have a Microsoft framework, which is a cross-platform. All right? This is the .NET Unified Platform diagram. I'm not going to cover this. Let me take you to the another paragraph where .NET 5 is equal to .NET Core version next. So in the second option, you can see expand the capabilities of .NET by taking the best of .NET Core, .NET Framework, Xamarin, and Mono. So you might be aware of what is .NET Core and what is .NET Framework, but you might not be aware of what is Xamarin and what is Mono. So let me take you to the Microsoft page where they described about Xamarin. So Xamarin is an open source app platform from Microsoft for building modern and performant iOS and Android apps with C# and .NET. So if I go by this video, which has been specified here, so with the help of C# and .NET, the code written on these language and these platform will work on iOS and Android apps as well. Let me take you to the Mono website. So Mono is a software platform designed to allow developers to easily create cross-platform application part of .NET Foundation. This is sponsored by Microsoft. It is an open source implementation of Microsoft .NET Framework based on ECMS standard for C# and Common Language Runtime. So the Microsoft plan for .NET 5 is to get best features of .NET Core, .NET Framework, Xamarin, as well as Mono, and put all these features in .NET 5. Another statement is, produce a single .NET runtime and framework that can be used everywhere, that has uniform runtime behavior and developer experience. So that we already described, that you write your code in C# and .NET Framework, and that will behave uniformly across the platforms. So these blocks and these statements looks really promising. But these blocks and these statements are from Microsoft peoples. Let's see what the world have to say about it. As to be honest, I don't have budget to conduct any survey. So let me take help of survey conducted by Stack Overflow. And this is the most shocking result for me, that ASP.NET Core topped the list of most loved web framework. That means, and mind it, these are the survey conducted on 2020, probably on Jan somewhere. So these are the survey from Stack Overflow. So this simply means that developers who are working on .NET Core willing to continue work on .NET Core framework, and developers from other framework who are using other frameworks are willing to work on .NET Core platform. Let's move on to the next slide. So when we focusing totally on the web framework, jQuery still top the list, but ASP.NET is at number 4th and ASP.NET Core is at number 6th. Don't get confused here with the percentage, that might confuse you. So let me explain you that I am a .NET developer. I am aware of ASP.NET, I am aware of ASP.NET Core, I am aware of jQuery, and I am also aware of Angular. So my vote will go to all 4 technology. So that's why there is a percentage variation, and you can see that might be over 100%. In the next slide, let's see the popularity of programming, scripting, and markup languages. Although this video we are comparing the .NET frameworks, but because C# is generally associated with .NET, so I thought of including this survey as well in this video. So here JavaScript topped the list, and if I talk about Python is at number 4, Java is at number 5, and C# is at number 7. Not bad actually. Let's go beyond the popularity and let's see the average salary and job openings in USA language wise, and the source is Indeed. So Python topped the list with average salary of 74k, Java is at second position with average salary of 69k, C# is at fifth position with 32k, and PHP at 7th, Ruby at 8th, Swift at 9th. Let's move on to job vacancy trend for .NET Core. And the source is IT Jobs Watch, and this is the graph for job vacancy trend in United Kingdom. And this graph is proportion of all IT jobs, not only the .NET, all IT jobs advertised. And that has been increased to 5% in Jan 2020. Definitely not a bad growth. I know this video became a bit lengthy, so let's quickly sum up. So is .NET Core is going to be the future of .NET developer? In my views, if you are a .NET developer, you should learn .NET Core. Will .NET survive against other open source technologies? If I talk about the previous versions of .NET, it already survived long and still surviving when it was not an open source, not a cross-platform. But with upcoming, or it's already launched .NET 5, it is going to be the cross-platform as well as the open source. So in my views, it will definitely survive. Your thoughts might be different, so you can let me know your thoughts and comment. That's it from this video. Thanks a lot for watching.